So good morning. Look, I've come down to Portlet Bay and wasn't going to bother today, but the sunrise looked like the cloud was going to be good, and it is. And the high tide at Portlet Bay doesn't appear to be quite as high. There's definitely space on the beach, and it's coming in definitely. But the bit in front of me where the tide is at the moment, beyond that, it's a bit kind of rubbishy. It's a bit kind of seaweedy and looks a bit dirty. So actually, this is perfect. It's another 2 hours for high tide, another hour for sunrise. But this is the blue hour, and you can see already the hint of a sunrise coming up. So I've got the GFX out, we're going to have some photographs, we're going to have some fun, and I'll record it as we go along. So yes, finally a good sunrise on Jersey. The first exposure is 2 minutes long, 100 ISO, f/14. Got this rock here, and the castle, and it's almost like two castles here. I don't actually know. I ought to find out. I'll put it on the screen if I can find it for you. There's some lovely, lovely rocks going through here. There's no light yet, but there is some nice colour in the sky. So gonna go for this. I might have to focus stack this f/14 with this rock in front of me in focus. It might mean the infinity depth for infinity isn't, so we'll probably do two or three exposures and blend these. But this looks like it's gonna be absolutely magnificent. I really enjoy the blue hour photographs, they're really, really nice, but yeah. There's no light to speak of. It's actually been quite hard on the GFX to focus up because it's so dark. Even though the sensor can pick this up, the screen, the LCD screen, it's really struggling in this lack of light. But I've put it onto single focus. And that will mean that the computers on the sensor will, that's the right phrase, will pick up the focus point, so it should be focused fine. Manual focusing is just really tough. I mean, if this doesn't come out, it's not the end of the world, because we're going to get some light later on, definitely some side lighting on this castle is going to look great. There we go. Wow. Okay, let's just do another one and then I'm going to show you what I'm getting. Still using the cable release. I don't think that's in focus. See where it goes. It seemed to go blurry. Might have to do that one again. Actually, if I cancel it, I just press back to cancel. There we go. Yeah. Oh, I don't know. It was in focus, I think. Let's try it. I'm going to put it onto a point. That's better. So I focused it on a point at the top of the rock where it's in the sea. So there's a bit of contrast there for it to pick up on. That should work. I'll get back to you. So I've come back to my bag. I've put my bag back to the beach because the tide is coming in quite quickly, and I grabbed, because even though it's early, the sky is still brighter than the foreground. So I just want to hold that back a little bit. These are looking excellent. So I've got the foreground rocks here. It's a little bit of light now, just kissing off the side. Castle. I've got really low with the tripod because what I don't want is this middle ground being too much negative space. So by getting lower, I can bring the ratio of the rocks, the castle and the mid-ground to about the same amounts, and then the sky. If I was really up high, I'm going to have a lower little bit of rocks, then a huge great bit of water, and a little rock at the top. So by getting lower, I'm going to make all of those elements level. Right, we just focus it up. Get the grout in place. And that is looking amazing. If I bring you over closer now, we'll have a look. So this is now our 52nd exposure, so it's come down already. And this is looking absolutely beautiful. I've used an F14, 52nd exposure, focusing on the rock. You can see the second one in to make sure the depth of field is going to be strong enough. I'm still going to focus stack this. And the reason why I can do this with this sea is because it's not rough, it doesn't matter. It's going to blur anyway. So actually, the two images blurred together, it won't look too bad. If you wait for this, got another second to go. You probably can't see that, but I'm well happy with that. Oh, so the light's coming out. We've got another 20 minutes to sunrise, and it's absolutely glorious. Even now, it's just really subtle, beautiful colours. The tide is coming in, but it's so gentle and lovely and peaceful. I'm now on 15th of a second at F14. I've got a 3-stop grad, and I really do need it, because if I take it off, the histogram disappears off the right-hand side. So I'm really having to hold that down. Just managed to keep hold of the highlights, and the shadows are already smashing onto the left. So the dynamic range of this camera is great. That's better. I'm really happy that I've got everything, all the shadows and all the highlights are on the histogram and looking neatly packed. So all the information is there. I think if this was a X-T4, I'm not sure that would be the case. Now we're pretty sure that in front of us the tide's going to come up quite quickly. I'm just going to wait for it to go around this rock, so I've got a really nice composition which I've already got sorted. So I'm just going to wait now for the tide to just come round, and then we might have to make a sharp exit because we're going to get wet. So I'm down to 1 second exposure. We've moved further across the beach because we're in danger of getting cut off where we were. So I've had to scramble across some rocks, but it's now sunrise. And I suspect, there's a big ferry going across. I suspect that what will happen now is the sky will burn out because it's very subtle. There's a lovely cloud top left. I'll show you the photograph on the screen, which I'm trying to get in. I'm on pretty much wide angle as far as I can get, making sure everything's level. And we've got a nice little triangular composition, which works well. 1 second exposure, F14. I've got grad on the front because we're still getting a bit of burnout, but with that there, actually, it's absolutely fine. Using the screen to focus, And there's a big ferry going past. We'll see if we can get that in. It's going to be blurry though. I'll wait till it goes behind the island actually, because I'm not going to be able to photograph that properly. So here it goes now, and I can now take the picture, and only you and I know that there was a ferry behind that island right at that point. I think I'm just going to take another one, focus stacked a little bit closer in, because just in case the depth of field isn't good enough. So let's do another one quickly before the ferry turns up, and that looks wonderful. What a brilliant day. So there we go. That's the last of my images from Jersey. It's been an absolutely wonderful trip. Still got another day left today, so we're going to explore the island, do a bit of touristy stuff. It's been an interesting vlog, this one. Started off recreating a couple of old pictures, which I really enjoyed doing for the memories, really. And then, obviously, last night at Clermont wasn't the best because I'd forgotten about the tide, but that's just a lesson on local knowledge. And thought this might end up being a long exposure vlog. I guess it has been a little bit, but today has been very special. Almost abandoned it, but I'm so pleased we came out. This is a beautiful beach, really, really lovely. It's called Portlet Bay in Jersey, and if you ever get a chance to come over to Jersey, then you should. Okay, so it's an absolutely wonderful island. So I'm just going to play with a few more little abstracty shots. Going to have some breakfast, and then we're going to do some touristy stuff. So thanks ever so much for tuning in. If you wait to the end, there'll be some pictures in a minute, and there might be an interesting thank you to my mate Tim, who's been brilliantly following me along, getting up really early in the morning, and been brilliant company as ever. So there's a little thank you to him at the end. So if you want to watch that, brilliant, thank you very much. If not, see you next week. If you haven't subscribed, please do so. Like the video, all that kind of stuff. Until next week then, goodbye.
Turn up the dial. You know what you gotta do. Get wild. You ain't gotta play it cool. Get wild. Take a rocket to the moon. Get wild. Get wild. Get wild. Show. Turn up the dial. You know what you got.